Kickflip is a film about a man who rediscovers the joy of life at the age of 40 through skateboarding. Catch it online as part of the Kota Kinabalu Film Festival.
Now, after the worldwide economic crisis in 1996, Parliament passed a controversial act called the Danaharta Act. It was copied from an Indian statute called the SICA, Industrial Companies Act, or SICA. SICA in India was enacted to detect SICA or potentially SICA Indian companies which owned industrial undertakings. The SICA made provisions for their revival and, if possible, their closure, if not. SICA aimed to release investments locked up in SICA companies for productive use elsewhere. Now, in contrast to the SICA, the 1998 Malaysian Act gave Danaharta very strange and questionably wide powers. For a time, the courts accepted the Danaharta's powers as gospel truth. One High Court judge ruled that the 1998 Act had been enacted for the sole purpose of saving our then collapsing Malaysian economy in the aftermath of the 1997 financial crisis. The Act did not achieve its avowed purpose. The legal carte blanche given to the Danaharta began to be increasingly questioned. There were sound reasons for this. Danaharta could take over liabilities from the financial institutions. It could bully debtors into submissions. Some long-established legal defenses could not be raised against Danaharta or his officers. For example, the 1998 Act had an odd provision that prevented anyone from taking any injunction order against Danaharta or its servants. Section 72 of the Act said that notwithstanding any law, a court could not grant any orders against Danaharta or its servants. But how does one challenge a law enacted by Parliament, particularly when courts regarded statutes as sacrosanct and inviolable? Practicing lawyers saw all this as being unconstitutional, which takes us to the case of Tan Sri Dato' Tajuddin Ramli against Pengurusan Danaharta Nasional. Tajuddin had taken various business loans for his fleet of companies, some of which he had defaulted. Danaharta took over these loans. It restructured Tajuddin's liabilities. Tajuddin could not satisfy Danaharta's terms of repayment. Eventually, what happened was Tajuddin and Danaharta entered into a settlement agreement, but Tajuddin struggled with interest repayments. Danaharta demanded Tajuddin repay overdue interest. Tajuddin thought about it and said Danaharta couldn't ask him for the kind of interest it was demanding. He resolved to stop Danaharta from enforcing its rights under the settlement agreement. He asked the courts to restrain Danaharta with an injunction. The judge, Mr. Justice Vincent Ng, ruled that Section 72 did not breach the federal constitution. How the judge said it is quite fascinating. He referred to a verse in the Bible. Now, you know the Old Testament. It speaks of the old prophet Job. The prophet Job had endured terrible privation in obeying God. Despite his anguish, Job declares his faith, his resignation and obedience in this world. Naked came out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thither. The Lord gave, and the Lord had taken away. In a case called Kakatong versus Danaharta Urus, the Court of Appeal criticized this view. Mr. Justice Gopal Sri Ram held that Section 72 of the Danaharta Act was unconstitutional, for it had breached the equality provision in Article 8 of the Federal Constitution. He ruled that an interlocutory injunction could be granted against Danaharta. Why not? He asked. The Court of Appeal pointed out that Section 29 of the Government Proceedings Act merely prohibited permanent injunctions and not temporary restraining injunctions. Some 15 years later, in January of 2018, Dato' Sri Gopal Sri Ram, who had retired but who had delivered the decision in Kakatong, spoke of the Sedition Act 1948. Now, the British government had enacted the Sedition Act in Malaya. This was before Malaysia's independence. The constitution defines any written law before Merdeka as existing law. Thus, under the constitution, the Sedition Act is an existing law. It's interesting that under Article 162, all existing laws were to continue in force after Merdeka Day, subject to any amendments made by federal or state law. Now, the Constitution limits free independent law. Article 162 limits free Merdeka law in certain ways. Let's see what it says. It says any court applying the provisions of any existing law after Merdeka Day may apply it with such modifications to bring it into accord with the provisions of this Constitution. Article 162, subparagraph 7 defines the word modification as amendment, adaptation, and repeal. The Sedition Act 1948 cannot be enforced, Gopal Sri Ram argued, because it couldn't be enforced. He pointed to Article 10, paragraph 1 of the Constitution, which guarantees the freedom of speech. However, Article 10.1 was cut down by Article 10, paragraph 2. That clause in subparagraph 2 stipulated that Parliament, by a fresh act, could limit the right of free speech. Article 10.2 permitted Parliament to enact such restrictions as it deems necessary or expedient in the interest of the security of the Federation. So, although the right to free speech was a guaranteed right, it was not an absolute right. It was a delegated right because the delegation occurred in Article 10.2. So, where a court is confronted by a pre-Merdeka law that deprives a person of constitutionally guaranteed rights, then the court should do its utmost to modify the law to bring it in accord with the Constitution, argued Sri Ram. Now, Gopal Sri Ram concluded it with these words. Therefore, he said, the Sedition Act is very good. Excellent. As I've said, the Home Minister can frame it up in his house, but he can't prosecute people under it. You can do any gymnastics you want, he said. You can do anything you like, but you cannot convert pre-existing law into a law passed by Parliament. It is not a restriction imposed by the later Parliament. Now, this example demonstrates that the judges acting under the Sedition Act had both the jurisdiction and powers, but they couldn't act under it to limit free speech because it was right, unconstitutional. They were obliged to strike it down. This video was helped by my friends in Langkawi, by Fisol, by Adi, and by Zo. They helped me a great deal. Look at this, total darkness, and these guys left all their work to come and help me. If you like this video, press like. If you haven't already subscribed, please share it widely with your friends. I hope to see you again. Thank you and good night.
Kickflip is a film about a man who rediscovers the joy of life at the age of 40 through skateboarding. Catch it online as part of the Kota Kinabalu Film Festival.